Hello everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. Today it's time for a haul video. And as you can see, I have some wonderful things to show you. You might have seen those new paint pens that I got, I think right before my vacation. And I already made a video about them and how I like them and why I like them and but I think I didn't show them in a haul yet. So I found on YouTube, I think. Was it on YouTube that I saw a video, or did I find them in my local art store? I cannot remember. It doesn't matter. I found new paint pens. Those are similar to the Posca paint pens. They are in a lot of different sizes, a lot of different colors, and yeah. But they have some nice extra features that Poscas don't have. Because besides, there are a lot of different nibs. You can swap out the nibs and replace the nibs. But you also can refill them. So if you used up your whole marker, you can refill it by a refill bottle, and it's so easy. You can simply screw off the refill extender. That, yeah, some of them come directly with. You can fill your ink in the barrel. You can screw it. Close a can, shake it up, and you are ready to go. This is a twin marker, and they have the refill extenders already on them. This is a different size, and they don't have the extender, but you can buy them open stock in different sizes for different paint pens, and you can pop it in between, and yeah, you can refill it very easy. The first time it will get a little bit messy because you have to put the extender in between. But yeah, it's okay. Just for one time, right? And then you're good to go. And the best thing is you don't have to throw out the marker every time you use it. So yeah, I really like them. I have played with them in my coloring books. You might have seen it in my last month's video. You will see it this month on my completed pages video. And yeah, those are the colors that I cut and started my collection with. I started with just some open stock ones, and I expanded them with those colors. It's a tropical set. You can find them on Amazon, and yeah, I love them. I really love them. And there are 74 different colors at the moment. So yeah, plenty. And then you also are able to buy an empty marker and mix up your own color. So if the color you're really looking for isn't there, you can mix it with refill bottles. Yeah, huge fan of them. Then I also picked up some of the luminance pencils. Some green tones. I'm using a lot of greens. I love to color nature pages and leaves, and yeah. So when I was in the art store to pick up those paint pens, they had some in the display that I was looking for, and for a good price. So yeah, I'm ready now. Good to go. Then, when I was on vacation, I got a nice YouTube payment. And I will say a huge thank you for everyone that is watching my videos. And yeah, every time someone is watching my videos, I get a little bit of it. And once in a while, I think it's every 4 months, every 5 months for me, then I get a YouTube payment, and I'm so happy with it. This month I decided to extend my collection for the Molotov Paintings. So I picked up the purple set. It's called the violet set, and yeah, I'm so happy with them. There are a lot of different sets with, yeah, six color families, and yeah, slowly I will collect them over the time, but really watching my videos makes it possible, so thank you. Those are the colors. I swatched them out and I think they are lovely. Really great for backgrounds, and some are dark, some are, yeah, lighter, more pastel colors, so perfect. I cannot wait to have a play with them. I didn't use them yet. I just have them, yeah, 2 days now. Yeah, I cannot wait to have a play with them. And let's see. Also, with this YouTube money, I ordered this book. I saw this one on Shell's Coloring Journey, I think. And at the moment I saw the book, I was thinking, oh, this one is so cool. I really would love this one in my collection. It is by Marabou. And yeah, the paper in those books is amazing. So let's have a look together. Yeah. I didn't break the spine yet. So I just had a quick flip. And there are a lot of bugs and insects in this, yeah, book. So if you don't like it, you can skip the part of the video and yeah, I will see you later on in the video. But this book is all based on insects under the microscope. So they are enlarged and yeah, combined with all the nature elements and some fun elements. It's a perfect one. I really, really like it. And yeah. The lines of some pages are more bold compared to other pages, and I'm totally fine with it. I don't mind it, and yeah, I love it that there are some gardening pages for the springtime, but then at the same time there is this more foresty, yeah, mushroom page for the fall season with the chestnuts and yeah. This one is perfect for the summertime. The strawberries and the ants are eating them. And yeah, I think you can create a lovely realistic page with them. But at the same time, you can draw in all your purples. Why not? And create something very fantasy-like and yeah, fantasy-full. Sorry. Oh, yeah, I'm really liking it. I'm not a person that's really into insects and crawling animals and no. Nothing for me, but in coloring books, I'm really liking it. So much fun. Especially those pages, right? With a nice scenery and then a huge big beetle in the front of the page. Yeah. Or this one with the big butterfly. I think this is the one from the cover. Yes, it is. So you can see, you can create very nice rainbow colors on your page. And yeah. There's a fight, oh no. And those will be eaten by the plant. This is a horror scene, right? Yeah. I can see myself living here in a cabin in the woods. creating a nice fire with wood and yeah, sitting there seeing the sunset, and will be a lovely summer evening. Oh, she already put my chair there. Yeah, a lovely, lovely book. I cannot wait to see other people coloring in it too. And if they will approach it with a more realistic look of the page, or end up with, yeah, a rainbow, of course. That'd be really interesting to have a look at those. I think this one is very fun. More smaller, you can test some color palettes on it. You can dive in with different pencil sets and use them as tester pages and tester objects. And yeah, this one I don't like at all. So yeah, you can test everything out and see what works the best on paper. But I think all the art supplies will work great on the paper. It's wonderful paper. And in the back there is this, yeah, overview of all the pages, and you can see the names of the artwork. Wonderful, huh? So thank you so much for watching my video, and yeah, you made it possible for me to add this one to my collection. Then I went on vacation. And in the Netherlands, we don't have very big supermarkets to do your groceries. Not compared to Sweden, really. And in Sweden, there is this large section of books. And also coloring books. So it was a nice surprise to find a coloring book on my vacation while I was doing my groceries. And yeah, I had to pick it up. I didn't have it in my collection. I really liked it. So move this one out of the way and show you my souvenir from the vacation. This is the only thing that I picked up from my vacation. It's a Mili Marotta coloring book. I don't know if there is. Animals Adventure is the English name of it. So, yeah, let's have a look together. And yeah, it's special. Really special for me, and I think it's a very thick one compared to all the books. Let me, yeah, can you see? This one is, yeah, very chunky. I think there are a lot of pages in this one. When I first started coloring, I think it was my third coloring book. It was a Mili Marotta one, and my fourth coloring book. It was just right after Joanna Desford. So I didn't break the spine yet. And I always like to do it carefully. But I love it when my coloring book can lay flat and you have the room to really color into the spine. And as you can see, it is really flat. The paper is bright white. It feels smooth, I must admit. It is different from the other books. I don't know if I will like it the same as the other books, but I really like those pages. Pages with birds. A lot of birds. Yeah. Sometimes it's really nice to have a more simple page like this and just go on mindless, all the little bits and things on the page. And yeah, sometimes I like it to use it as a tester page or just simple with some gel pens. See you swimming those otters. Ah, beautiful. I really like those pictures. But yeah, you can just pick up a little set of pencils and mindless color them in and having fun with them. Yeah. But I think it is Betty Hun, if I'm right. She creates the most beautiful art in those books. Really. And you barely can see it was Milly Marotta page, right? She get rid of all of the textures. Oh, nice one for the winter page. I'm sorry if I'm too slow, but I'm really having a look at all those pages now. And I did a quick flip in the store, and when I was on the road, I didn't want to sit there and have a look at my page, because I know if I'm looking at those beautiful pages, I really like to start coloring. And yeah, I want to do a flip through first for you. So yeah, I love this seahorse. I can see myself this color this one with Derwent graffiti tint. I like to use them on sea life. Another seahorse page. Really smooth paper. I don't know if I will be really happy with it. It was a nice one. I've seen plenty of reindeers on the vacation in the wild. I spotted them. So, lovely experience. Now let's. I will try to go a little quicker. I always like to color a crab in the summertime. A swimming slot. Oh. Yeah. Beautiful book. I'm really happy with it. And I hope I can have a nice memory when I start coloring in the book, and the nice memories from my best road trip, and yeah, can bring back my memories. That's what I wanted to say. Yeah. Oh, I would love to color those. I can't remember it. Perfect winter page. So many lovely ones. I have a few Milly Marotta books in my collection. I was a huge fan of those books when I first started coloring. And then I got distracted with a lot of different other illustrators and didn't feel like her new books, and I'm happy with this one. This one might be a best of book, right? Because I have colored it. I have colored this page. I'm pretty sure with my Derwent metallic ones. So I think it's a best of book, and That might be the reason why it's a pretty chunky one. That's okay. Normally I don't buy compilation coloring books because I own a lot of the previous ones. But for this one, yeah, totally fine with it. I don't own the most of the previous ones, so. This one is screaming springtime for me. Yeah, and there's the list with all the names. I cannot read it. And there is this test page. Beautiful book. Yeah, really want to start coloring in this one. I really hope I have some time this month. And then I left the best for last. So my husband was scrolling online and found a set. And he was asking me, do you have those pencils? And I was like, yeah, I have it. But do you have them in a set? And I was like, no. Do you want them? Was his question. I was like, yeah, I might want them if the price is right. So he showed them to me and we were able to buy them for a great price. And it was so fast. I already got them the next day. And can you guess the pencils inside the set? Those are old pencils. That's the first hint that I want to give you. The second thing that I can share is they are not made anymore. It's a discontinued pencil brand. So let me take a sip of my tea. Do you already know what's inside? You might recognize the emblem, right? Do you know the logo? The branding? Let me show you. Those are Charisma pencils. There's this sticker with the color numbers, the names inside. And those are the aquarelle pencils by Charisma. And I already had them in my own pencil roll, pencil case, and I didn't have the original packaging. So yeah, for the price that we were able to get them, it was a great price and I'm really happy with it. And yeah, I had some of the pencils that they were very little, and it's fun to see that the pencils that I already owned were little are longer in this set, and the ones that I have brand new are smaller in this set and more used. And yeah, when I first got the pencils, they were really dirty and well used and loved by the previous owner, and I always like to clean them up. So I made a little video and I think it will be on my channel, yeah, maybe next week. And I show you how I clean up used pencils that I get, and yeah, they are ready for me to use. So this is the last thing, a great addition to my pencil collection, and I'm so happy with them. I got them from my husband, a present, so thank you. And yeah, this was everything. I have some books on the way. I didn't want to wait to film and show you the things that I got. So yeah, the books can wait, and the books are pre-orders. I think it is the one by Emily liet er al over weg dat hij pre-ordered en de nieuwe Camilla one. And there was another one. It was out of stock. So, yeah, I have to wait for it. It is the Joseph Kettenbang Wild Summer. So, yeah, I will show it to you. I'm sure you all know the books that I ordered, and I will show them in the next haul video once I receive them. And I hope you enjoyed the video, and I really hope to see you next time again. And let me know, what is the favorite new art supply that I got this time? So, thank you for watching, and I really hope to see you next time. Bye!